Okay, comment, Councilmember Lutz.
Well, I'm going to oppose the motion. I think that we need to accept the findings of the Planning Commission on all the items. I think that the staff has made an excellent point that the general plan does provide consistency with this change. The land use regulations and existing uses do fit into the property that we're looking at. If we look at community development on our general plan and land use 2.3, it requires that infill development be consistent with the scale and character of the existing areas. I think this certainly fits in with that. Community development 2.6, preserve architecturally important historic buildings capable of being adapted for viable reuse. If I'm looking at a picture of the neighborhood in front of me, obviously these buildings are architecturally significant, being built at a certain period of time and at the same time in Salinas' history, and I think this is a very creative, adaptive reuse for the property. Community development 3.5, the mixed use is consistent with the area's architectural and historical character. The fact that the owner would like to keep the buildings and use them without changing them says to me that indeed this is consistent with the land use regulations for the existing area. I think it works well. I think that we would have a hard time finding coming up with the findings that we would need that we can't have the negative declaration, and I think that we'd have to have our attorney come up with some kind of reasons to actually oppose this. So I'm going to not support the resolution, but I will support the staff recommendation.
Okay, anyone else from? Okay, I am.
Can I speak?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't see it. Sergio, go ahead.
You know, what this issue, folks from this area have come to us many, many times about the impacts of the traffic in their communities. And we have tried voluntary stuff, and we've done traffic calming devices. We've done now meter parking or paid parking. I mean, all kinds of different things. And the community is saying, we just want to stay as a residential area. And somehow we just keep bringing this kind of issues forward. So I support the motion for the simple reasons that I think it's the most convenient for the community not to have it there. I think there's plenty of office space throughout the city. I do support it, but obviously not there. The other one is what is the greatest benefit to the greatest number of people? And if we keep it residential, that is the greatest benefit for the community. It might be compliant with all the general plan and all the requirements and all that stuff, but I think we gotta think about the community, and the community lives there. They are already bearing a lot of traffic, a lot of necessary traffic. We're dealing with buses, with taxis, with cars, with employees, a lot of people out there. And you know, and whoever decided to move there at one time is because the hospital used to be by itself there, and there was nothing around it. It was just farms. And now everything, either the residential creeped up on the hospital or vice versa. But the bottom line is we need to look at what is best for the community. What's best for that community is not to have more commercial there. So I don't support the 109, definitely support the changes on Abbott, and those are my reasons to support it, and hopefully this council will support it, because that's what this resident has been saying for a long time. Help us with this traffic. Don't bring more traffic into the area, and even if it's a couple more cars, it's still traffic. So that's the reasons I'm supporting.
Okay, anyone else?
I'm going to support this staff recommendation, also on the land use regulations, but it's been stated that it's going to be used just for billing, so that is why I'm also supporting. There's not a lot of foot, or I don't think it'd be impacted by a lot of traffic.
Okay, Kimberly, and then Jill.
I'm inclined to support staff recommendations, Planning Commission recommendations as well. I think we are working hard to improve business in the area, and I commend you for trying to grow your business, and I will be supporting that.
Okay, thank you, Kimberly. Jill?
I just wanted to make sure, because I Gloria had brought up about, you know, it's going to just be used for billing, and I just want to make sure that everybody understands that the uses that are not permitted are, when we change the zoning, if we do, restaurants, financial services, commercial recreation, entertainment, and industrial are not permitted. They will not be permitted, even should we change the zoning. In addition, anything that, like a bed and breakfast, retail, schools, all that requires a conditional use permit. So this is not going to be a huge impact on street parking, lighting, noise, or landscaping, which are critical issues in a neighborhood.
Okay. Question then I'll make my comment. Each change on the street on a go forward basis would have to go through the same process. So this notion of creep would have to be vetted one by one by one, correct? Okay. All right. Thank you.
Would it be appropriate to amend my motion at this time to move forward with the two subject properties that it sounds like at least two, maybe more of us support, and then pull the third subject property?
Well,
out.
We're going to call for the question,
okay,
and see
sure.
How the
fair
and
enough,
then
enough.
And then my guess is there just may be a flurry of counter motions.
Sounds exciting.
So we'll see, and flurries can be awfully exciting for a council. So I am going to.
Can you clarify the motion for me, please?
Okay. Anne, could you read back the motion?
The motion was to introduce the ordinance without 109 Catherine Avenue property.
Okay. All right. I'm not going to support the motion for a couple of reasons. I think it's important in the clear light of day to believe and presume that this council or future council can be disciplined enough to respect the concerns of the folks who have homes. And the reality is the same activity is going to go on by the billing group. The same number of patients are going to come. So that I don't believe there is any material change. And because each residential property would have to be considered one by one by one by one, I think there's enough of a protection for the residents' concerns. And it's fine to say there are other options, but the doctor doesn't own them. And in an uncertain world, just as we have fiscal challenges, the healthcare world has its own challenges. So in terms of managing costs and trying to make things happen, there may be a little bit of a, we're splitting the baby here, but I think the edge has to go to a belief that that this council and future councils can be disciplined, will be sensitive to residential concerns, but it is important to also, I believe, respect the rights of the property owner that is just frankly making kind of a tactical or an accent piece type of decision for activities that are basically going to occur under all circumstances in terms of amount of people and that sort of thing. I do appreciate your concerns about, and I hope the doctor will be sensitive to, on an after hours basis when there are not when there's not a family in a house, that's a different situation. Certainly, as all of us move throughout Salinas, we see that more and more, and I think that frankly concerns me the most. But I think at the end of the day, this is one of those ones you kind of put it on a scale and you weigh it, and I come down on the side that it is, that there are enough checks and balances on a go-forward basis, that the property owner is making a reasonable quest within the context of the immediate neighborhood and looking across the street and nearby. So I will be voting against the motion, and I will ask the city clerk to call for the question.
Councilmember Barrera?
No.
Councilmember Craig?
Nay.
Councilmember De La Rosa? Councilmember De La Rosa, I'm sorry.
Yes.
Councilmember Lutz?
No. You are no.
Councilmember McShane?
You're no.
Yes.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Mayor Donahue?
No.
Mayor? May I make another motion, please? I would like to approve the staff recommendation for the general plan amendment and rezone.
Second.
And the only other thing I would add is that perhaps it might be a good idea if we all kept our general plans right here next to us, because it's just easier for us to look at and refer to.
Okay. All right, comments?
Yeah, would the maker of the motion be willing to separate the other subject property from 109 for purposes of a separate vote?
No.
No? Okay. Okay.
Okay. The motion to approve staff recommendation has been, there was a second, I believe?
Yes, there was.
All right. Call for the question.
Councilmember Barrera?
Yes.
Councilmember Craig?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Yes.
Councilmember Lutz?
Aye.
Councilmember McShane?
No.
Councilmember Sanchez?
No.
Mayor Donahue?
Yes. Okay. Motion passes. All right. Thank you, everyone. All right. We will proceed to the next public hearing item. Boy, you're... Okay. All right. Mr. Wiles, you're busy this evening, and we are going to talk about a proposed swap meet. Council Member De La Rosa has to recuse herself from the discussion, so...
I have to recuse myself, and I could have a potential conflict of interest through a family member.
Councilmember Craig
We're going to send you to Gloria. We're going to send you to an undisclosed location. But you may stay in state. Okay. You're in the community now. All right. With that, Tom.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mayor Donahue, council members. This is a proposed outdoor market to be located at the Salinas Sports Complex at 1040 North Main Street, assessor parcel number 003-231-0200. The applicant is Mr. Lupe Campos in association with the California Rodeo Association. It is on city-owned property. The Salinas Sports Complex is located along North Main Street. It includes the swimming municipal stadium, this aquatic center, Sherwood Hall. The proposed outdoor market would be located on the western side of the sports complex along the North Main Street frontage between the box office and the rodeo grandstands. The proposal is for a maximum of 118 vendors. For Sundays only, it would be 42 Sundays a year. The operation of the outdoor market would be from 9 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Vendor access would be from 7 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. The applicant proposes it to be a central location for vendors. Alcoholic beverages and live entertainment would not be allowed with this outdoor market. This shows the outdoor market site plan actually is looking along actually from the north, actually east and west are on the top and bottom, north and south on the left and right, and shows the North Main Street down at the bottom, and then the vendors between the grandstand and the box office. The Salinas Sports Complex is located in the public, semi-public zoning district. Surrounding uses include commercial, primarily the Sherwood Gardens Shopping Center to the west of it along North Main Street. There's also public and semi-public uses, including to the north of the Department of Motor Vehicles. There's also residential uses located to the west, over to the west and to the east and south of the site. City Council Resolution number 18280 was approved by the City Council to allow for a maximum of a 5, what they call flea markets. It's interchangeable with outdoor markets, 5 per year, pretty much to match what was the zoning code. And then the City Council, as part of it, will need to increase the maximum number of such flea market or outdoor market events from 5 to 42 with the proposed outdoor market.